how long you can take to say, no, this is not going to work, I'm not going to do it. You can be trying for 1, 2, 3, 4 years. I guess there is some point that someone is going to say, this is not going to work for whatever reason. Right now I may say the economy, right? But how long we can be dreaming this. I wish I can hear from someone with expertise, you know, how long we can keep trying.
Right?
Anyone could answer that.
Well, I mean, there's no easy answer, but I think that, you know, sometimes it's under the obstacles part, but sometimes it's also the excuse, okay, it's the economy. And there, it's partially going to be the economy, but I think it's looking back and saying, okay, what am I selling? And maybe I need to change my concept. I mean, it's like what you were talking about earlier. If you're like, maybe I need to talk to someone who has resources in China instead of trying to do something on eBay and those things. So I think that, in my opinion, I would probably go back and kind of look at what I was doing and see if there's other ways to approach the situation. But, you know, it's...
There's so many ways to rebuild everything. If you get your goal within 3 months, get maybe 10 customers or 40 customers, and you can get only like 5, then you have to find out whether you're doing wrong. Because we are not perfect. And if something is doing wrong, it's because you are doing something wrong. You have to rebuild. You have to rebuild and review. What did you say? What did you do? What did you do? And at this point, you have to know which one you
have to do.
No. Like my aunt, she had a...
You leave them by. Get out! Don't come back!
But you are not being polite.
No, I don't do that. If you're going to extremes, since you are asking, ask yourself what you do wrong, that's why I'm feeling guilty.
Yes, think about that. It's probably you are, or maybe you are not doing something. You need something and you have to do something else. You always have to want to extra mile.
Think about it, right? Yes.
Like my aunt, she has an Indian restaurant, and the first year that she opened, you know, they were like, oh, we're going to get all of these customers. They've been in Houston for like 25 years, obviously they knew the community. And like within 6 months, everyone stopped going. But no one told her. And then one day, me and my sister and my brother were like, we don't even want to eat here. Because she was using, like, because of the quantity, she had a buffet style, you know, restaurant. She was using like frozen and, you know, canned things, and it really changed the flavor of the food.
Yeah.
But it was saving a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And I think that she had to really, I mean, they ended up shutting down for a year, and then they redid their whole idea. They had to open it up under a different name again, and, you know, just really start from scratch and say, okay, well, what is it? And then they changed their market, so they started attracting more like non-Indian people that weren't stingy and they would pay for food. And I mean, you know, I know how like white people are sometimes. They kind of like, can I get a discount? And they're like, oh my gosh, you know, it's already so cheap. So, you know, I think like it was thinking about those things. Yeah, I mean, Yeah, they think like everyone's family, and you're like, okay, well, it's already $7.99. I mean, how much more can go? So, but you know, I know it was difficult for them because they were like, you know, it's a personal reflection on confidence. But my aunt cooks really well, so I think that she had to really step back and say, okay, what do we need to do to change this? And then, you know, now they're doing really well. So it's been, they reopened like a year and a half ago. So, yeah. But, you know, it's more work, and then they ended up, like, changing some of their recipes, and when you know your own family doesn't eat there, you're like, okay.
Speaking and asking questions. This was the most very way to know people in the yard. People could be lying at once. Second question, you know when you tell them, or know when you engage with some personal. That's why I'm saying all the time, personalizing. For example, if she had a boyfriend and she is with a boyfriend and you start talking about problems, they could be more open than, and you have somebody with a kid, or a teenager, and you know how difficult it is. Then, you get engaged with them. With some simple question in regards to the demon, you know. Then they start to be more open mind and be more friendly and this is it's a lot of security. Yeah. Yeah, you have to, what's the most amazing thing in sales?
One thing that I know is something I do if I notice someone's hair or a particular lady or someone beautiful skin like I'm I usually give the person compliment to appreciate that and they open up to me to I notice that when I try to or your hair is amazing.
Probably you could call them back. Oh, my name is Elsa and I'm calling you because I meet you in the fair in, I don't know, San Francisco. Oh, Elsa, and then I'm, oh, my colleague, hey, oh, yes, nice, how are you? Then, how are you feeling? Or something, and also you could remind them the question. Or the chat in the garden we have before, and they just really remember.